they're capable of doing me dirty work.
We're going for a little ride into Epburn Heights. Kill me some filthy Diablo boo-boo's been batting up me Lady Queen Lizzie. You do the driving and the shooting and the dallying a boot. We'll make sure you don't get cold feet. Here, you'll need a piece.
Laughing vampires dance!
Let's drive.
Liberty City, arise! You're listening to Aris the Pacifist One on
inspiration.
And exactly what have I inspired you about?
Well, okay, right now I live at home, but pretty soon, like...
Alright!
Dude, that B dude was bogus. Really bogus. That's all. Great show, Laszlo.
I appreciate that. That's why I went to broadcasting school.
Alright, when we come back from these messages that help supplement my meager salary, we're going to talk to Reed Tucker. It's going to be a great interview. We'll be right back.
A good shoe starts from the ground up. At Aris, we make high-quality footwear. In fact, you can find Aris running shoes in over 140 countries around the world. In the past, there's been some criticism about our workers. That's why I'm here at one of the Aris factories so you can meet some of them. Excuse me, sir. Do you enjoy your job here?
It's fun. We get to play with knives.
I see. Is there a real sense of teamwork?
My friend Joey sewed his hands together.
Wow. You're learning some real skills. How about the salary and benefits?
Yesterday, I made a dollar.
See, that's the kind of dedication we have to our employees and the quality of our shoes. Aris Running Shoes. Always running from something.
Buying a gift for the guy that has everything? Log on to PetsOvernight.com. We've got exotic pets galore, including tigers, cobras, manatees, and white rhinos. All delivered over...
Burn ice. Rescue me some filthy Diablos. Remember, doing this to the end, man. Hold your corner.
In the studio, we have a very special guest. His new book, Karate and Digestion, has been on the top 100 self-help books for the past 3 weeks. He is the founder of Now and Zen Dojo and Organic Food Mart in Trenton. His name is Reed Tucker. Welcome to Chatterbox, Reed.
Why, thank you, Laszlo. It certainly is an honor to be here today.
So tell me, Reed, where did you think of the idea of combining martial arts and organic food? I mean it's kind of like putting ice cream on pizza. Both are great, but they really shouldn't be put together.
Okay, Laszlo. Actually, it is nothing like ice cream on pizza. Ice cream is milk-based, as we all know, and I am lactose intolerant. And pizza, as you may know as well, is a sandwich derivative of Italian origins, but I won't go on. Martial arts are about discipline and physical empowerment, not watching football and eating junk food. You have to explore your mind and your digestive system, Laszlo. What you put in,
especially corn. What's the story with that anyway?
Laszlo, I'm deadly serious now. My mentor was a 430-year-old monk who showed me the way to enlightenment through character.
Okay, you have a question for Reed. We'll be taking calls in a little bit. I think we all went through a ninja period. You know, I had the Chinese stars and the nunchucks.
This is not a period, Laszlo. This is a way of life. Thanks to a strict vegan diet, I had the power of 9 men. After morning meditation and a 3-bean salad, I could chop a bus in half. Sometimes, I even frame myself.
No offense, but you're kind of a scrawny, pasty dude. It says on the inside cover of your book that you still live in your parents' basement.
Okay, it's not a basement. I prefer a center for spiritual enlightenment. In chapter 17 of my book, which I know you've read, I address the dangers of cynicism. Laszlo, a closed mind is like a closed fist. Karate means open hand. But it might as well mean open mind. If you like deep breath, I think you'll really like it.
Well, I'm not a masticating cow, so I really don't enjoy chewing damp hay and prancing around in leggings, shouting,
Okay, Laszlo, I'm warning you this time.
Okay, that should do it. Now get us back to the yard. Go, 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 now!
That's the martial arts I can stand up fully, just like you. And I encourage everyone listening out there on Chatterbox to buy my book and learn how organic food and martial arts can help you too.
And I encourage anyone who needs a doorstop or a booster seat to buy it as well. Let's see who's on the phones.
Laszlo, this is your final warning. Do not make me go into my dragon's dance.
Hello, caller. You are on the air.
Hello, Reed. I bought your book. It really saved my life.
Why, thank you.
I wanted to ask about chapter 29, yoga, not yogurt. I just can't give up cheese. So wonderful. I rejected chocolate milk and tapped butter out of my life. I've scooted around the house with my legs in behind my head for 2 days now. But my husband says I look like a chicken exorcist. I even put on the dairy on the top shelf of the fridge so I couldn't reach it with my legs in behind my head now. But I grew weak and start knocking things down with the room. What can I do, Reed?
You're not threatening each other. Keep serving. Shut up, you carnivore. Why don't you go gnaw on a bone like a gorilla bad, though? Our ancestors didn't eat chicken wings. They lived at one with nature and their ecosystem, subsisting on a diet of nuts, berries, and leafy vegetables.
Yes, and they threw stones at their own shadow and died of old age and fear at 24.
Laszlo, the soul is eternal. But let me answer the question. When I'm in trouble or tempted by those all-you-can-eat breakfast buffets with huge pans of juicy bacon...
Can we get some bacon in here?
Laszlo, I go back to bacon. I start the day with a fruity beverage, some meditation, and 6 hours of yoga. Next, I go open up my shop, now and then, and drink 2 pints of hand-pressed potatoes.
And who wants a steak after that? Okay, next caller, you are on Chatterbox with Reed Tucker.
Yo, Reed, Kung Fu movies are dope. How can I learn to beat up 10 guys at once?
Okay, first things first, my man. You need to stop the negative thinking. And the best attack I've found is to just run away. That way, you'll instill fear in them. You never know when you might descend from the rafters like a bat.
I don't want to hear about those Kung Fu running away. I want to learn about being a ninja.
Actually, I do cover this early on in the book.
Okay, you're the kind of man we like as friend now. You're Irie, man. Real shooter.
Organic vegetables. Just look at me. I could tear a phone book in half with my bare toes. In fact, that though. I can easily chop this desk in 2 half desks.
This desk is made of 2-inch thick composite wood pulp.
I want you to steal me some gang cars so we can do some naughty thing on our enemy turf. I want me a Mafia Sentinel, a Yakuza Stinger, and a Diablo Inferno so we can hit up any gang in Liberty. Drop them off at the garage in Newport and hear this. They're no use to me, all broke up now.
The tacky sack. Maniac.
Nowhere, I think I'm gonna hit you now.
Oh, I brewed heathenry. Don't throw any tofu or bean curds at me.
Be very funny, lad, though. You didn't make fun of me, but it's all the fault of the feng shui in here. Downright disgraceful.
Yes, it makes you talk like this. Okay, the listener lines are open. This is Chatterbox. You're on the air.
Hey, Laszlo. That last guy was a lunatic. Where'd you dig him up from? The state movie bin? And that wacko you had going on about Killer Bees? What a moron. I mean, just read in the paper. Killer Bees, the equals of artificial sweeteners and soda pop, Roswell. It's all part of the government's propaganda plan. I might as well wear a satellite dish. This propaganda right into my brain. Come on. Do you honestly believe the NSA's echelon system is already reading your emails and recording your phone conversations? They already got me once, but never again.
Do you have anything else to say?
Yeah. Free Kevin!
All right, we're talking about short guys, killer bees, the Magna Carta, Well, the red light on the wall is flashing, which means that the owner of the station has an important announcement to make. Let's go live to his office.
Hello, my name is Donald Love. You're listening to a Love Media station. Enjoy.
Wow, man, that was deep. You know, I really like working here. The station, it feels like my second family. Except that we have a snack machine. And I tell you, working here beats the hell out of digging sewage ditches outside Kuala Lumpur. All right, let's go to the phones. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Well, little man, I was listening to that English wimp you were talking to earlier. I mean, do these guys realize how wussy they sound? I mean, they... I mean, what's up with that? They all think they sound so smart with the little funny accent. I mean, I got something for them. Speak English, you limey moron.
Well, you know, I think they were speaking English before we were. The people over here were speaking Shoshone and Cherokee.
Man, Cherokee, Shmerokee, man. And another thing, what's up with them calling soccer football? Man, you ever watch soccer? Man, that's a boring game, man. Yeah, I'll tell you what soccer is. Soccer's for little girls, man. Football.
In the Navy. Here's
a dollar.
I'll tell you, I bet you played ball. Look, I'm running around the court bouncing the ball and I'm 7'3". I'm telling you, man, I only play men's sports, like football and hopscotch.
Hopscotch? That's a girl's game.
Man, that ain't a girl's game, man. Not rugby hopscotch. Man, get me in a scrum and I'm dating. I'll take anybody down. I'm the hopscotch master. I got wide skills in hopscotch. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, yeah.
Red in the family. I'm hot and you're not.
With our three-step program, you'll rediscover romance guaranteed.
Hi, my name's Phil. I've got three kids, two cars, and a mortgage. My love life is going to stay, even before my wife's car accident. Then I called New Beginnings. Thanks to Fernando, I'm still married. But on Wednesday afternoons, I meet Barbara at the motel by the turnpike.
See? The passion cheese back. Phil's marriage is saved, and his kids will have a daddy to look up to. Call New Beginnings today. 555-922. It will be a miracle. I guarantee it. Fernando's New Beginnings. We turn an ending into a new beginning.
Mom, there's a package for you.
But I didn't order anything. What's this? How sweet. Gee willikers, it's a puppy.
Everybody loves a puppy. And now you can ship one anywhere just by logging on to PetsOvernight.com. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
And who says that e-commerce isn't a brilliant idea? All right, speaking of brilliant, you're listening to Chatterbox with me, Laszlo. Let's go over here to the phones and see what's plaguing Liberty City. Oh, caller, you're on the air.
Wow, I got four... People are rude and they don't seem to care about anything but themselves. Perfect example. The other day I stopped at the store to pick up an exercise bar from the Hunt Time Breakfast for lunch. So I go up to pay and the lady's like, $1.25, please. So I get out my checkbook and the guy behind me is like, oh come on lady, you don't have $2? And I said, as a matter of fact, I don't. I spent my last $2 last night buying gas at these ridiculous gas prices. And besides, who are you anyway? Can't you see that I'm wearing my I Walk Sure t-shirt? People are so considerate.
Well, you'll get no argument from me. I mean, I get every inconsiderate moron in Liberty City calling into this show. I mean, people think that I have no feelings whatsoever.
Exactly. Another perfect example. The other day, I'm over at the hospital to have lunch with my girlfriend, Marie, and this maniac comes right up on my bumper, flashing his lights, and I'm like, hey, guy, the light is red. You can't just come up behind me, honking, flashing your lights. Then he gets over this megaphone and says, to the woman in the Steal My Batsu monstrosity, please leave the side. Can you believe it? I mean, who has a megaphone rigged into their car? People are so obnoxious these days. And rude. I mean, I call my name. My kids some manners.
You know, I think that's a lesson to us all. All right, hello, next caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Hello, Laszlo. Did that woman say she was a nanny? Because Freddy needs a nanny because he's been a very naughty boy.
No nannies. Let's go to our next caller. All right.
Colonel James P., United States Marine Corps, 2nd Battalion. Laszlo, that caller made a really valid point. These kids today have no respect for authority. and there is one thing that would whip them into shape.
Let me guess, the military.
That's right. The military teaches you respect, obedience, and gives you a good pension. These kids that thought they were going to be millionaires, look where the super information highway has gotten them. Nowhere. It's a dead end. Uncle Sam takes care of his boys and some girls. If more people would join the military, this would be a better country. I tell you another thing about respect. These kids don't respect.
I got myself a big
smoking on Chops and Mars.
Tell me what this Australian-American war was. I mean, I really never heard of it.
God, not another one. Have you read a history book lately, son? The Australian-American War was the biggest war since the Big War. I tell you, I didn't do two tours and take boomerang shrapnel in my head so I could come back here and have a bunch of hippies deny history. Those Aussies are right. David wired kangaroos with his horses. Come hopping in again. Knock out 10 guys.
Well, thanks for the history lesson. All right, let's go over here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Is that Maslow?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
My name ain't important. It's real unimportant, okay?
No, not really. I mean, this is a radio show. People usually tell us their name.
My name is real unimportant. And you want to keep being a wise guy, you'll find out just how unimportant. Like, unimportant, I just got shot in the head, unimportant. Do I make myself clear?
Yes. Why are you calling in today?
Because I need some advice, and I ain't doing any of that shrink shit.
If you swear again, we're gonna have to cut you off. This is a family show.
Sorry. I'm just a little unhappy, a bit agitated, real angry. It's my mom. She don't think I'm a real man. Can you imagine that? I mean, I do a bad job at home, but she treats me like a little boy. All I get is, your pa this and your pa that, and you ain't a real man, Tony, and it's driving me freaking nuts.
Well, Tony.
I want you to steal me some gang coffee.
You're a good son, and I want her to show that she cares for me. Show that she loves me. And, you know, say I was a good kid. It seems like nothing's ever good enough for her, you know what I mean? What do I do?
Well, Toad, I mean, sir, you know, in life we have a lot of obligations. And you just kind of have to face up to them. And right now, I'm obligated to play some commercial announcements. We'll be back right after this.
We've got a new friend for everyone. He's got fur and a tail. He gets in lots of trouble, but he's a bouncy little fellow, because he's got springs for legs. Pogo the Monkey, the best new video game for the whole family.
I love you, Pogo. You bounce.
Help Pogo escape from the evil research laboratory, where the mean old scientist genetically altered him.
Uh-oh, the pharmaceutical scientist is going to get you, Pogo. Here you go, Pogo. Have a gold coin.
Good thing Pogo has a banana cannon. Those nasty scientists deserve to die. Now get the shampoo manufacturers before they squirt it in your eye.
Here you go, Pogo. Have a diamond.
You'll guide Pogo through tons of fun adventures, including saving Timmy, who fell down the well.
Here you go, Pogo. Have a big watch.
Rescue a cat out of that tree with your banana cannon, Pogo.
Here you go, Pogo. Have a fast car.
And help Pogo to his final mission, to storm the White House with his friends and become President of the United States. Pogo the Monkey is the game kids are sure to stare at for hours. Everyone loves Pogo. Idiot gamer called Pogo the best spring and simian game since bouncing bananas. Buy the game Pogo the Monkey today. Right, Pogo? And coming soon, Pogo the Monkey card game, Pogo the Monkey plastic dolls, Pogo the Monkey glove covers, Pogo the Monkey card covers. Your dad who has everything, why not a Pogo the Monkey tie and sports jacket? For the lady in your life, why not Pogo the Monkey chocolates and hygiene products if she smells like a real monkey? And for kids, a life-size, living, breathing, springing monkey. All available at PogoTheMonkey.com.
All right, Liberty City, this is your talk radio show, Chatterbox, where your opinion matters. Let's go to the phones. Hello, caller, you're on Chatterbox.
Pigeons are good too.
sometimes they come with notes attached. It's like a fortune cookie with wings. Squirrels, not so good. They taste like goldfish. Meat real stringy. You know what I mean?
Actually, I can't say that I do. But if I did eat too much squirrel and put on a few extra pounds, I'd use the Dormatron. Unlike those other exercise machines that require you to be awake, the Dormatron actually exercises you overnight. Let's learn a little bit more about it.
I've tried everything, and I just couldn't keep those extra 200 pounds. I've had my mouth sewn up, my hands chopped off. You name it, I've tried it.
Yeah, except for exercising and eating right, Balky.
That's right, honey. Then I found the Dormatron. Using a new technology called biorhythmic subconscious gymnastics, the Dormatron exercises you while you sleep. Just strap in your arms and legs, put on the Dormatron headset, then wrap yourself in the special high-voltage electric blanket. Turn it on to 11 and burn those pounds away while you have a relaxing night's sleep. Now that I've lost 280 pounds, my husband's all mine again.
That's right, honey. No more escort services for me.
Don't be fat a day longer than you have to. Remember, being fat can even ruin a romantic cruise. Call Dormatron now at 1-800-SLEEP-OFF-LARD or visit www.sleepofflard.com and sleep your way to a thinner, happier you.
I'm a marketing manager who lives in the suburbs and commutes to work on a highway. I live alone, so of course I needed a car that could seat 12 and is equipped to drive across modern country. It just makes me feel better.
The new My Boxu monstrosity. Mine is bigger.
Oh, well, that's a good commercial. I love commercials, don't you? This is Chatterbox. We are taking your calls right now. Hello, caller. You are on the air.
Hi, Laszlo. Is that your real name?
Huh? Of course it's my real name.
Are you Hungarian?
No, I'm from upstate.
Are you sure that's not a fake radio name like Andy and Bobo? I thought all those radio people had fake names.
Do you have a question or you just want to sit here and talk all day about my name?
No, that's it. Love to go, Laszlo. Or Mark. Or John. Or Bentley. Whatever your name is.
All right, next caller, you're on Chatterbox. What is on your mind?
Turnips, fruit vegetables, albino carrots as they're known back home.
Okay, here's the deal. This isn't Gardening with Maurice. That's on later.
No. He got taken off the air. He lied. I know he did. I've been trying to make a hybrid of a peach and a Pekingese midget fighting bitch for the last 2 years. And it is impossible. Impossible, I tell you.
Okay, and speaking of impossible, Jane from Cedar Grove is on the line, and she wants to talk about how difficult it is being a parent today. Hello, Jane.
Hi, Laszlo. I love the show. I'm a first-time caller. I wanted to say something about these video games. They are warping our kids' minds. My son's dog, Hugo, got hit by a truck, and he says, Mommy, Mommy, where's the reset button? Kids these days, they think life is a game. Well, it's not a game, Mommy. It is very serious. I let my kids play video games, and now runs around the house looking for gold coins. This is teaching our children to go chase money.
But this show does. Ah, I love that button. You know, it's never a dull moment on this show, especially if you're in our key demographic.
Love Media, bringing people and the finest in entertainment together.
All right, hello, next caller. You're on Chatterbox.
I want to talk about that fang stuff. Don't say it's bad. It's not bad to you at all. Why are you talking to me? Right up here. Hello? It's you, family.
What's your question?
Bang, 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 bang.
What about it? I mean, that's not really a question. Questions usually start with words like how and why, and they end with your voice going up like this.
Don't mock me. I know where you work. You're just another rat.
How's that?
All right, it's evil, dude. And who says...
Somebody caught a man!
that note, it's been 2 full minutes since a commercial. But I'd like to say, if anyone else is stressed, might I recommend Equinox from Zybatsu Pharmaceuticals? We'll be back after these important messages.
Hello.
I used to be concerned and nervous about the future. Sometimes I'd get scared before an important event such as childbirth or a family funeral. Hey, sometimes you need a little help navigating life's trouble spots. That's when I discovered Equinox.
After the divorce and losing little Tommy, life was getting me down. I couldn't focus on anything at work. After trying Equinox, I've been employee of the month 3 times in a row.
I used to fall unconscious for hours at a time. Now with Equinox, I never need to sleep.
Equinox is new from Zybatsu Pharmaceuticals. Ask your doctor about Equinox today.
Equinox may cause nausea, loss of sleep, blurred vision, leakage, kidney problems, and breathing irregularities. Do not take Equinox if you're operating heavy machinery, driving a car, pregnant, a childbearing age, unhappy, or have a family history of mental disorders.
Equinox, softening life's harsh realities.
Guys, equip them with grenade launchers and flamethrowers, and let them hunt each other down. It's the reality show where you just might be part of the action.
I was grabbing a sandwich at the Happy Blimp, and all of a sudden these guys crashed through the window and started shooting at each other. I was so excited, I didn't even notice I've been hit. After that, I was hooked on Liberty City Survivor. I watch it every day in the hospital.
The game doesn't end until there's only one man left standing. Tune in nightly or watch the 24-hour live webcast. Liberty City Survivor. Natural selection has come home. Sponsored by Ammunition.
All right, we're back on Chatterbox. Call us on the Chatter line to tell us what's on your mind. Line 4, you're on Chatterbox. What's on your mind?
Liberty City Cox rule!
Ah, that's lovely, thanks. Next caller, you're on Chatterbox.
I'll put this on the top shelf. Hey, what's the weather like down there? How's it going, short stuff? Can you get that? You're closer. Why so sad, Pee-wee? Who do you think you are? Short people are people, too.
All right, another award-winning show on Chatterbox. Today we're talking about anything, it seems. If you have something to say about anything, call now. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah, I love the show. Love hearing people's opinions. That's what made this country great. People, opinions, and stuff. Most of all, guns. I had a piece of wine about guns kill people. Guns don't kill people. Death kills people. Ask a doctor. It's a medical fact. You can't die from a bullet. You can die from cardiac arrest.
I hope you recover. You're gonna pay for that.
And countries that don't have guns ain't America.
You know, that's a really good point. Countries that don't have guns aren't America. You know, if more people had guns, we'd have less shootings in this country. All right, we're going over here to line 2. Hello, caller. You are on Chatterbox.
Yeah, I'd like to say something about taxes.
You mean the Lone Star State?
Oh, taxes. Well, you know, look, taxes are really wrong. My father worked his whole life. He played the lottery. And now the state wants to take taxes on the money he wins from that stuff? Buy your own lottery ticket, you know? Hey.
Good point. I think that's a lesson to us all. All right, hello. You are on Chatterbox.
Hello, lad. No, I'm a first-time caller. I recently moved to Liberty City from Hampshire, England.
Oh, really? How do you like it? I mean, is it hard to get used to the language? You speak English pretty good.
Oh, thank you, man. Yes, I do like it. And what I know is very good, not worried. When I was a boy in England, I had a nanny. She was very good, man.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's excellent child care here in America, you know.
Well, I'm sure. But the thing is, lad, though, when I was a naughty boy, I would get spanked. Nanny would spank me when I was naughty. And now Freddy needs nanny, because when Freddy's naughty, he needs to get spanked.
Well, there's some child psychologists who probably say that spanking can be harmful to a child's emotional development.
Leave me alone!
This guy a green card. This is Chatterbox. We're talking about short guys, nannies, taxes, and anything sane you'd like to bring to the party. Hello, you are on Chatterbox.
I was listening to that caller about taxes. Views were a little extreme. How do you expect to be a responsible member of society if you don't understand how the government spends your money? I mean, the Cartesian coordinate system has an elemental power I find liberating, even sexy. I'm not ashamed to say it.
Okay, thanks for calling. Now that we've lost 98% of our audience, let's reward the other 2% with a commercial. When we come back, we'll have a special studio guest. Special because he advertises on this radio station. Remember, it's not a conflict of interest if we own all the radio stations in town. We'll be right back after this message.
In today's fast-paced world, a split second can be the difference between achieving your dreams.
Hey, I just won the Nobel Peace...
at House of Tomorrow, and they'll set you up with all your 21st century technology needs.
I only spent $20,000, and now I can get email in the shower or surf the internet while I'm driving. I was bored stupid at my daughter's recitals and my son's Little League games. But thanks to House of Tomorrow, I can play wireless head-to-head 3D virtual reality poker literally anywhere.
If it's a flash-in-the-pan technology of absolutely no use to anyone, you can find it at House of Tomorrow. Remember, only technology makes...
Fernando's New Beginnings.
Truly, Laszlo, it is a miracle, a blessing. It is a revolution in the marriage life. For my people, marriage is, how'd you say, sacred. The bond between the father and the mother, it is made in heaven and in the bedroom, if you know what I mean.
I think so.
For my people, it is the holiest, most sacrosanct thing imaginable, like a church. Yet, for it to be a happy marriage, it must also be like a brothel. The woman, she must be many, many arts. Be skilled in making house, cooking, changing the diapers on the babies. And she must also be a whore, a vixen in the bedroom. Imagine it, constantly fresh. It is impossible. You change diapers and then you are a French maid? Fernando thinks not. Fernando knows not.
Well, I mean, you know, it's an age-old problem. I mean, how do you keep the excitement?
And I give you a big, big kiss, like I give a woman. But I am not going to give you a big kiss. Not a kiss like I give a woman or even a donkey. Because you do not know.
Well, I mean, in this case, ignorance kind of seems like bliss. I wasn't really up for kissing on air. I mean,
why not, Laszlo? Am I not attractive? Am I not irresistible even to you? Well, no matter. Why all this talking about kissing?
I mean, you brought it up.
No, my friend. You say you not want to kiss me. I was talking out to say... Impossible, Laszlo. If a man was born an angel, maybe impossible. But a man is born a man. And a man with needs. He needs a woman to tuck his babies into the bed. But for his bed, he needs something else. Something magical. Sweaty.
So he starts flirting with the secretary, takes her out for a drink. One thing leads to another, and before you know it, he's found all kinds of uses for the office furniture.
Exactly, Laszlo. I know what you are like. I see it in your eyes. A wanderer, a dreamer, a man who has needs, but an idiot. And I can save you. And I can save your marriage.
My marriage doesn't need saving.
Hey, you are the one mentioning the pretty assistant and the office furniture and the Aikarama, my friend. Listen, Laszlo, and listen very closely. Your marriage is a gift, it's a present from above. But you are a man. I think we see by now you are no angel. I can save you. For when the man, he sees wife all fat. pretty assistant. We already know that, see? Go on. But Laszlo, what if you act on your fantasy for your little secretary with the short skirt and the pretty eyes and come here, come there, smiling. What then, my friend? What then?
I get a sexual harassment suit.
If you are lucky, my friend. But you, more likely, your marriage is ruined. Your sweetheart, she hates you. Your pretty secretary, she wants you to be her man. You're back into square one.
Here you go, I got a present. Special delivery. TNT. Copy the cat.
Of bread 6.5 days a week, and the spare half day I save his life.
How?
By giving him what he needs in a controlled environment. I give him passion.
What, with you? That kind of sounds like a limited market.
Laszlo, you are very prejudiced. I don't like that. But no, not with me. Passion for life, passion for love, passion for winning, which he can take home to his wife.
What, so you act like a pimp?
Not a pimp, little man. A savior. In a control environment, I reintroduce the man to the pleasure he has lost, to the miracles of the world. And truly, the results are remarkable. With my unique counseling, 1,000 marriages have been saved, and 1,000,000 more could be saved every day.
And do the wives know about this?
In their hearts, Laszlo, they know they have been saved.
Okay. We're gonna open it up to the phones if you've got any questions for...
I'm a first-time caller, and I just wanted to say, hey, Laszlo, you're real tough on Fernando back there. I'll tell you one thing, he's a miracle worker. He saved my marriage, and I married a bus of a woman. Now I don't feel
special
sick every time I open my eyes.
See, Laszlo?
Yeah.
You see?
Delivery.
I remember Jerry so well. He come in, he is like
daddy.
A broken man. Like a half a man. A man, if you will. He has no end anymore. And his marriage... Whatever it takes to save a beautiful union, a blessing.
A beautiful union by an adulterer and Queen Kong. That's great. So, who's on the line now?
Hi, Laszlo. Janice. I love the show and always wanted to call in. You really offended me today. Who is this gutter trash you got on the show?
Hey, Janice, I share your anxiety. The studio kind of forced him on me.
Hey, you watch yourself, mister. And you, Janice, why are you so ugly? Your husband, he don't make you happy?
No, he's an idiot and a jerk.
But he's probably a good daddy, and you sound very pretty. Angry and a little bit of a know-it-all, but very pretty lady. This is the thing, Laszlo. The women they think in new beginnings is only for men. But no, it is for women too. For Janice, if her husband goes to new beginning, she thinks Señor Wonderful all over again. And in the extreme case, maybe she... You call me 555-9292.
Now listen, don't try to pimp out my listeners.
That is a very early word, a travesty. I work miracles, senor. Not painting. I save. I give the passion back. And you better wash yourself, buddy. Because for my people, we take these issues very personally. And then, you no longer Mr. Talk Show. You Mr. Who Cut Up My Tongue.
I got a present for you.
You think that teaching kids at an early age that violence is the solution to problems will make them valuable members of our society?
Exactly. I knew you'd understand, Laszlo. My daddy used to whoop the tar out of me. He once hit me so hard my sleeve fell out of my ear. It didn't do me no harm. Look at me now. I'm the best pest control guy in the world. I've killed more rats, roaches, and vermin than you can imagine, and I love it. This is such a great country. I wouldn't be where I am today if my daddy hadn't.
What are you talking about? Man, I'm starting to believe that guy about the fluoride in the drinking water. Listen, if there's any sane person left in Liberty City that can hear my voice, please call the show right now. This is SOS going out across the city. All right, let's go over to this line. Hello, caller. You are on the air. Are you sane? Are you a sane caller?
Absolutely, Laszlo. Killer bees.
Killer bees.
Yes, killer bees. Did you know that if the current migration north continues...
on and on into their cell phones. I'm really glad we get to hear about what you're having for dinner. What we should do is herd them up and put them on an island. I am the president of a group called Citizens Raging Against the Phone.
CRAP?
Exactly.
Your organization's called CRAP. What kind of moron are you? You want to round people up for using a phone? But you're calling up on a phone to tell the world about it. I mean, how many people are there in this CRAP?
Citizens are raging against phones, Laszlo.
How many people?
There are three of us. It's hard organizing meetings without the phone, though. We've had to resort to carrier pigeons, and they keep disappearing.
What are you speaking to me on? What's that in your hand?
I am not the problem. You are, and you're perpetuating the downfall of mankind. Liberty City was great before phones ruined everything.
Liberty City was a church, a cow pasture, and three houses when the telephone was invented.
Liar!
You're the liar.
Liar, liar, pants on fire.
What are you? Are you 3 years old?
Laszlo's a liar. Laszlo.
When trouble looms, the fool turns his back, while the wise man faces it down. The Colombian cartel have ignored repeated requests to leave our interests in liberty well alone. Now they are negotiating terms with the Jamaicans in order to humiliate us further. They are finalizing a deal across town. Take one of my men, steal a Yardi car, and go pay your respects to the Colombians. Our honor demands.
For injuries suffered in auto, bus, and train accidents, and can even train you to throw yourself in front of a bus and pretend to be injured. Hey, that's why they pay for insurance. Call the law offices of Rakin and Ponser and get ready to enjoy a life of luxury.
All right, we're back on Chatterbox. Let's go to the chatter line here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Laszlo, I just wanted to make your viewers aware that...
Okay, now, this is a radio show. We don't have viewers. We have listeners.
Okay. Anyway, Laszlo, I just wanted to make your viewers aware the first International Puppetry Festival is next month at the fairgrounds, bro.
If you're interested in becoming a puppet master or a ventriloquist, you should definitely come down, dude. It's going to be totally killer.
I wasn't aware that there was much demand for puppet shows these days.
Oh, man. You've been living under a rock, bro? You guys with puppets get chicks. I take my monkey puppet to the park all the time. We play hacky sack together. It's rad. But anyway, dude, at the International Puppetry Festival, we'll be having workshops on finger puppets, too. Hello, Petunia the Pinky. Meet Barry the Thumb. String puppets, club puppets. Dude, it's gonna rock.
Okay, thanks.
Hope to see you there, Laszlo. Hey, by the way, can you give me that guy Fernando's number?
Nah, I'm sorry. Fernando hasn't paid his bill to our ad sales department. But here's someone who has. And they paid us in stacks of old groats and gold guineas. We'll be back after this.
Do you live in the boring suburbs but dream of living in a lonely castle on a windswept moor? Do you long to trade in your sweatsuit for a 100-pound suit of armor and swap your SUV for a noble stallion? Do you eat microwave dinners, but all the while wishing...
At Liberty City Park, it's the Medieval Millennium Fair. Our band of traveling minstrels, knights, and maidens oh so fair are ready to delight you with tales of the Black Death, witch burnings, and the joys of being a feudal serf. Forget about air conditioning and modern medicine. We've got all the leeches, spells, and...
Liberty City, you are listening to Chatterbox, the show that is the number one reason for the success of the internet. All right, let's take a call. Who's on the line?
Close.
What about them?
Close.
What are you talking about?
Laszlo, close. Close, Laszlo. I hate them. I just hate them.
We're all about opinions on Chatterbox, which is Liberty City's premier phone-in station. But why don't you like close?
I just hate them. They're so constricting. I mean, does a line work close? And the lion is the king of the jungle. So why can't I, a humble citizen, go naked?
Well, I mean, I guess a lion has two distinct advantages over you. One, I mean, it's, as you say, a king, and therefore it can exercise its royal prerogative to not wear clothes. And two, it's a cat, and therefore it doesn't have to. And three, I mean, now that I think about it, if you want to try to dress a lion, you can, but I get... I'm gonna have to cut you off.
Don't you believe in free speech and free expression?
Look, is this leading anywhere? Because, I mean, we've got a lot of other people waiting to talk about real things here.
Nudity is real. Open your eyes. Take off your pants. Come on. Come on, Laszlo. You can be a figurehead for Liberty City Naturists. We have more members now for the...